Pressure is mounting for President Trump to give details on what prompted the strike that killed a top Iranian general. Comes as the funeral for Qassem Soleimani was held today. Thousands of mourners surrounded the coffin, leading to a stampede. 56 people were killed and 200 others were injured. Iranians continue to call for Soleimani's death to be avenged, but President Trump says the U.S. did everyone a favor by killing him.
He's been called a monster, and he was a monster.
During an Oval Office meeting with the Prime Minister of Greece, President Trump defended the decision to kill Iranian General Qassem Soleimani, saying his death was a good thing for a lot of countries.
He was planning a very big attack and a very bad attack for us and other people, and we stopped him.
Well, they're either based on misinformation or they lie.
But Iran's foreign minister told CNN Soleimani was on a peaceful mission to contain anger in Iraq following the murder of about 25 Iraqis by U.S. forces. Defense Secretary Mark Esper balked at that, saying Soleimani has conducted terrorist acts around the world over the past 20 years and has the blood of hundreds of American soldiers on his hands.
This is no innocent man. This is a terrorist leader of a terrorist organization, and his time was due.
Iran's foreign minister reaffirmed to Iraq that Iran will retaliate for his death.
This is state terrorism. This is an act of aggression against Iran. And it amounts to an armed attack against Iran. And we will respond. But we will respond proportionately, not disproportionately, because we are committed to law. We are law-abiding people. We're not lawless like President Trump.
It's the right decision. We got it right.
Secretary of State Mike Pompeo defended the decision to kill Soleimani as entirely legal and appropriate. But a fierce political debate rages over whether there was an imminent threat of danger.
What we've heard so far from this president are tweets, threats, and tantrums. All we've heard from this administration are shifting explanations, evasive answers, repeated assertions of an imminent threat, without the necessary evidence to support that conclusion.
Now, Soleimani was killed in Iraq, and the outgoing prime minister of Iraq says the U.S. has no alternative but to pull its troops out. But the president and Secretary Esper says we are not leaving. The president said it would be the worst thing to happen to Iraq.